Hi and welcome to my YouTube automotive channel. Today I will show you how to remove and replace the radio unit on a 2008 Chevy Impala. This video applies to Chevy Impalas made from 2006 all the way up to 2016. It is a good idea to disconnect the battery before you start taking everything apart. Main reason because you might burn a fuse when you are disconnecting the radio. And the second reason, you'll have to disconnect this airbag sensor right here. And if you don't disconnect the battery before you do that, you might end up with airbag light on once you start the vehicle for the first time. And then if you don't have like expensive scanner, you might have to take it to a shop or to a Chevy dealership to have it reset for you. Okay, the first thing to do is to pry out this plastic trim piece that's surrounding the radio and the climate controls. Now to do that, the best thing to use is like a plastic trim remover. If you don't have one, I don't have one, you can use something like this and then just put a piece of duct tape over it just to make sure you don't damage any of the plastic parts. Okay, so what you want to do, just pry this trim piece all around, and once you have it pop out on one of the sides, you can pretty much just use your hand to completely remove it. Okay, so the next thing what you can do is just disconnecting the disconnector here at this airbag sensor. There's the clip just on top of it, so you can press on it and pull it up. Or the other option is you don't even have to actually disconnect it, you can just pretty much pull it up and it's gonna be off your way. So whichever is easiest for you, do that. Okay, now you have gained access to a couple of Phillips screws or a 7mm, whichever tool you have. So pretty much you'll have to remove these two at the bottom first. So this guy here and the guy on the other side, just because you'll have to move the climate control a bit out because there is a radio lip just underneath it. So in order to remove the radio, this has to get off the way. Okay, so these are the screws. Now you can just get this off the way, and as you can see, there is this radio lip on the bottom that was stuck just under this. So yeah, and once you move that, you have four more Phillips screws, the same type, so two on the left side, here and here, and two on the opposite side as well. So here and here, so remove those four. Okay, those are the screws, and now you can pretty much pull the radio straight out. On the back side of the radio, you'll have the radio antenna right here, which just pulls straight out as well. I'll have to use both of my hands, or I won't. Okay, this is your radio antenna, and then you have like two connections here. So there are two clips here, you can see, one here, one here. So pretty much what you want to do, just click onto it and you can pull each of these connectors straight out. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. This is how you remove the radio from Impala. Very easy to do and much easier than on previous models from 2000 to 2006. Now one more thing which I will mention. If you are planning to replace this radio with a different factory OEM radio from a different Impala, for example, make sure to get the radio code as well. If you don't get it, what might happen, and it often happens on these Chevys, once you connect your new radio into this Impala, it's gonna ask you for the radio code and you won't be able to use the radio. Now the radio code usually comes like on a small card, size of a business card, and it's a 4-digit number usually. If you get the radio without the code, your other option is to call the Chevy dealer and give them your new serial number of the radio, and you will need to give them the serial number of the donor vehicle, and then they can give you the code. But most likely you'll have to pay for that between $50 and $100. So If you're getting a radio from the salvage, there is always lots of Impalas. Just walk around, check the glove boxes. Usually those radio codes are like a part of the owner's manual, and if you have it, then you're good to go. If you're replacing this radio with the aftermarket radio, first make sure to get the proper wiring harness. So for example, if you're getting like a new Kenwood, you will need a wiring harness that on one side connects to these two connectors and other side will fit your Kenwood radio. Same thing goes for the Sony or whichever other company. You can get those wiring harnesses online or at any audio store. And second thing you will need for the aftermarket radio is the radio kit for that specific radio. So the purpose of that is once you install the new radio, it nicely fits into this hole and it all looks nice and original and there is no moving parts or holes or stuff like that. Okay, thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. If it was, please like it and consider subscribing to my YouTube automotive channel. On my channel, you can find lots of how-to videos, do-it-yourself videos, car reviews, product reviews, and other similar automotive topics.